Today, I am in a fairly sizable desert landscape which contains abundant sand that completely covers the ground and towering sand dunes. Yet, from the get-go, something immediately looks wrong. There are pine trees everywhere, which are best suited for a cold climate. And if we pan to the right, we can see mountains which contain snow and glaciers. This location is no ordinary desert, as wild moose can sometimes even be found here. And no, we are not looking at Great Sand Dunes National Park in Colorado, which is located high in the Rocky Mountains at an elevation of 8,200 feet. Instead, this desert is located in the remote interior of Yukon, adjacent to the small town of Carcross, which is above 60 degrees north latitude. Known as the Carcross Desert and informally nicknamed the world's smallest desert, the reason for this dune field's existence is quite unusual, as this geologic oddity did not form due to extreme heat like most sandy deserts, but rather the exact opposite, extreme cold. To understand the origin of the Carcross Desert, we must first realize that it is actively shrinking. While 2.5 square kilometers are covered in thick sand dunes with minimal vegetation, around this spot in every direction there is a thick sandy layer which has since been overgrown with vegetation and trees. This is because this desert was once 6 times its current size, yet over time vegetation has reclaimed much of it, starting from its edge and moving inwards, preventing the formation of sand dunes. The origin of these sand dunes can be traced back to 22,000 years ago during the last glacial maximum, when more than 83% of Yukon was covered in more than a kilometer thick of ice. However, due to natural long-term changes in what are known as Milankovitch cycles, the planet was about to warm. For every year after the glacial maximum, a decrease in the thickness and extents of glacial cover occurred. When these prior glaciers had expanded, they scraped and carved away large swaths of rock, and over thousands of years, these fragments were further pulverized into particles of decreasing size until they reached the 1/16th of a millimeter to 2 millimeters diameter size geologists identify as sand, since sand is a mere particle size. As these glaciers melted, these sand-sized particles were left behind in the landscape, dropping to the ground once the ice disappeared. Due to the substantial amount of meltwater, much of this sand was swept by rivers originating from these melting glaciers, eventually finding their way to a series of voluminous lakes. By 11,500 years ago, the Cassiar Lobe Glacier had retreated to a valley just 1,000 meters southeast of the eventual Carcross Desert. At the time, the massive Bennett Lake had a much greater extent, with three connected lobes shooting off of it. Each of these lobes connected to the deepest point of the lake, which happened to be Carcross, which at the time was covered in approximately 110 meters thick of water. Over time, trillions of sand-sized particles were swept into the lake's lowest points due to a combination of both water currents and wind. As the glacier to the southeast further retreated, a fourth lobe opened up, causing even more sediments to fall on the area of Carcross. More than 100 feet thick of sand piled up, largely consisting of a metamorphic rock type known as quartzite. Once the amount of glacial ice that could melt each year decreased, so did the level of the lake, as it was slowly lost to groundwater, and the eventual draining of significant water into the Yukon River, which exited into the Bering Sea. Thus, as the lake level decreased, the thick sand layer became exposed for all to see. Over the following 8,000 years, wind blew particles in an uneven manner, causing the formation of large sand dunes and pushing numerous small particles onto the edge of a local hill. Vegetation then reclaimed much of the original dunes, with today only the original thickest layers of sand still being free of dense tree cover. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new channel member, Christopher Ngimu Darson, for supporting this channel.